This 26 Sports and CCTV High School Basketball presentation is brought to you by Munson Healthcare Cadillac Rehab Services.
Well, coming off what was no doubt a very physical victory in East Jordan, the Kalkaska Blazers on a back-to-back game night struggling as they trail the Cadillac Vikings 41-18 here in Cadillac. Jay Simon alongside Kevin Gregory with you here. And really, the Vikings have been able to impose their will on the Blazers. Pretty much everything they've wanted to do, they've been able to do. And Coach Ryan Benzenberg, in order to coach, has had to find little things to kind of coach up. And really, when you think about it, when you've got a 23-point lead, that's the best time to do it.
Right? Yeah, that's true.
Kids are going to be a little more responsive than when they're down 23.
So. Well, for the fourth game in a row, like you mentioned, you know, Cadillac's kind of sticking to their game plan and executing their game plan extremely well. There's really not too much you can say that they should or shouldn't have done in this game. So you got to find those little things and those little small teachable moments.
Foul was on Spencer Fisher, his first. Fourth on the Vikings. Just underway here in the fourth quarter from Cadillac High School. This 26 Sports and CCTV presentation. Boys non-conference basketball action presented by Munson Healthcare Cadillac Rehab Services.
And with 14 eyeballs over there on the Cadillac bench, there's not a lot that's going to go unnoticed.
No, there are a lot of adults on that bench as Fitch, I believe, attacking the rim, will draw the foul and go to the line for two.
One thing I do like to see right here, though, is you have, you know, senior junior. I feel like he's a senior, but because it's his second year. But you got Keegan Brooks out there with four guys who aren't starters and don't always get a ton of minutes. So showing his leadership and his floor generalness, if you will.
Floor generalness.
I just coined that phrase.
Word.
I like it. Say what I want.
Well, now they're going to give Tip Baker an opportunity to do that. As the freshman will join Kahani, Spencer Fisher, Jared McDaniel, and Hunter Rensbury on the floor. I coached varsity volleyball for 5 years, Kevin. I was lucky to have one coach on the bench with me. Kahani traveled, no call. Sorry. Quickly the other way, the Euro step from Fitch, can't get it to go, and then Fitch, trying to get the steal back, will commit the foul on Hunter Rensbury. I apologize, but...
He's a little one-two shuffle.
There's a little shuffle there. Listen, I will say it until the cows come home. The two most difficult jobs in the universe are officiating and mothering, and I want absolutely nothing to do with them. Listen, we talked before on other shows, and if you listen to me on the radio on CDY, I've talked about it probably a little bit more, but I have a source. I have a secret source, top secret source, who is an official with the MHSAA. As there's a nice look underneath to Jared McDaniel, who finishes. And my top secret source will occasionally listen to broadcasts and help me out with things that I don't understand going on the floor. We had one such situation a couple of games ago where Kylie Christensen had a ball near half court and was kind of throwing bows, right? Just kind of clearing space for herself. And they called a violation. They didn't call a foul. They called a violation. It was a turnover as Kahani lays it up and in. Gave the ball. I think they were playing Gaylord. Gave the ball to the Blue Devils. And we were utterly baffled. There was no foul call. Couldn't understand how they could be giving the ball without a foul call. And my secret source, who I texted because he wasn't obviously listening because we were taping at the time, as the three there from Ingersoll is off the mark, let us know that is a rule where if you excessively swing your arms, and it actually says that in the books, you can hold the ball tight and you can shift your body, and nobody can see me right now, but you can shift your body and move around because you're avoiding having somebody take the ball away from you. You're allowed to do that, but if you swing your arms in such a way as to in essence, in the official's opinion, you're being dangerous without contact. If there's contact, it's a foul. There can be no foul without a contact, unless it's a technical foul, as the tough shot there from McDaniel will give the ball back to the Blazers. But in this case, it is a violation. It's right there in the rule book, and that's exactly what that official called, and it was the right call. It was a perfect call as Fitch, three balls off the mark. Noah Zdradowski with the rebound.
So you're saying just because I never heard of it, that's irrelevant, that it's still a violation?
And I know that's hard for you to hear. I totally get that, as McDaniel's called for the travel. But yes, that's exactly what I am
trying to
say.
Well, we just saw a good bit of officiating here. The fella closest to us at half court right now, a couple plays ago, Kahani came out, set a high ball screen, rolled his ankle a little bit, laid on the ground for a minute, got up, tweaked, the play went on. As they were running down the court, motioned to him, hey, y'all good? Kahani gave him the thumbs up, and play went on. Didn't blow the whistle, stop play, but checked on the player. Nice bit of officiating.
Yep. 45, 24, and 42 to go in this one as Cochran gets it up and off the glass. Viking reserves getting some quality minutes here in the fourth. Zimmerman attacking the rim. Can't get it to go, but he will draw the foul. But Hayden Zimmerman is just fearless. And he will get rewarded with a couple of free throws. Both teams will be in the bonus with the next foul after this. Anyway, all that to say, in conversing with my super secret source, we were discussing how you don't see a lot of young officials right now. Most of the officials out here are closer to my age than they are, say, Darren Mickelson's age.
Sure.
Just to throw a name out there. Darren being in his 20s. And in our discussion, it was, well, it's because it's tough. It's really hard to be an official. It's largely a thankless job in the sense that there's not a single fan or a coach that thinks you're doing a good job, typically, right?
Well, one coach does and one coach doesn't on every play.
There you go. That's fair. And Zimmerman can't corral that loose ball, and it'll go over to the Vikings. But it's tiring. It's just constantly stressful because you know that somebody's going to disagree with every single call you make.
Right. So to do it and to do it well, you A, have to know the book like these guys do.
Inside and out.
To know your position because there's positional calls. You might expect one guy to make a call, but it's not what he's looking at the time. So you have to know that. And then you have to, thirdly, and most importantly, be confident in your call. When you make a call, own it, right? But also have the humility that sometimes if you blow the whistle or like we've talked about, they call it anticipation calls.
Yep.
And you blow a whistle, but it was really just a jump ball or a good block. Say, hey, jump ball on that one. That's my bad. So, and we see that a lot.
Well, I don't know that they I don't know that in an actual game, I think you're thinking of three-on-threes. I don't know that in an actual game, if you blow the whistle on a foul call and then you think to yourself, oh, maybe that really wasn't a foul, I'm not sure you can just call it.
You go jump
ball
on that
situation. Can you?
Well, I guess I've done it. Doesn't make it right.
You've done it in three-on-threes, or have you done it, like, you know, an official MHSAA game?
The most official game I've ever done was a city league. So, no, I don't do MHSAA games. I'd like to know from the super secret source, though. I mean, do you just have to own a bad call if you made a bad call, or can you say?
It's a great question. It's a great question.
And when you say super secret source, I almost hear you say super secret sauce, and then I need to go to Culver's or something tonight.
There's a three off the mark from Spencer Fisher. Well, to wrap that conversation up, in that ensuing text conversation, if you enjoy basketball and you feel you know the sport, you're doing these kids a disservice by not giving it a shot. Right?
True.
There's a lot of wannabe officials in the crowd. There's a lot of wannabe officials watching this broadcast.
What?
There's a lot of wannabe officials doing this broadcast.
That's true.
Sign up.
Yeah.
Go to the MHSAA.com, sign up, give it a try, right? Do you have the guts to stick with it? Do you have the tenacity to do it? My secret source has been doing this for several years. He doesn't feel like he's got it all figured out.
That's right.
He wants to get better every year. And a good official will feel that way as Fitch drains both those free throws.
And they're not done for free either. You can get a little bit of coin on the side.
You do. Absolutely. Absolutely. You make a little bit of money. But that's not what it's about. Since the switch of the seasons back in 2007, it has been very, very difficult to find enough officials to cover every game all week long. And they've been talking about it since 2007. And it is still true. So if you've got any thought, as McDaniel, the nice little drive and hoop, to helping these young men and women out by getting out there and being an official, we encourage you to do it. And then Kevin will offer you some feedback.
I will give you some fair and unbiased critique.
Perfectly reasonable feedback. 2:43 remaining in this one as the Vikings, with a comfortable lead, are going to move to 7-6. They're going to get back to over 500 for the first time since the sixth or seventh game of the season. As mentioned at the pregame, they started out 3-0, lost 6 in a row, but now this will give them their fourth straight win. And they seem to be putting things together at the right time as Stosio
well, 26 points with 2:41 to go. Gotta love Kalkaska still putting forth the effort, trying to get steals. Almost got one on that play. And you know, what else do you do? You don't just give up and let Cadillac dribble the ball out for 2:41. You work on stuff. Work
Absolutely.
On your traps, work on your rotations for the next game.
Absolutely. And Reimer gets that one to go off of McDaniel. It'll be Kalkaska basketball. 2.5 remaining in the game. Do you think the Vikings have that many coaches so that nobody knows for sure who the head coach is? Is that kind of like the whole wedding thing, right? The groom and his groomsmen look kind of similar, and that was the old days. It was so you didn't know who the groom was so that nobody could come in and do something wrong to the groom.
Well,
is
you
that
got
the idea? Coach Benzenberg can kind of blend in with his assistant coaches?
You got your varsity assistant, your JV assistant. You got Mr. Cooper there as your eighth grade coach. And Emmington has a vested interest in the program with his daughters playing. So, you know, just a lot of guys that willing to help out. And extra set of eyes never hurt me when I was coaching.
Nope. Jared Cooper draws the offensive charge. Two minutes to go in this one. Cooper working against Rensbury. Ooh, Reimer had Stosio on the cut. I'd have missed that too. Stosio, a little handoff for Fitch, puts it up and in. Chase Fitch with 5 in the quarter, 1.5 remaining in the game. There's a near steal. Fisher. Oh, nice look to Cochran down low. From Jared McDaniel. And we're going to get a timeout. Kalkaska will get a couple substitutions with 1:17 remaining in this one. Well, as mentioned, if you're watching this broadcast after the, just after the game, meaning Tuesday evening, you can watch the replay. I want to say the replay will be on Thursday, but head over to MyNews26.com and you can find the broadcast schedule and replays for all of our games. Again, you can go to MyNews26, find us on the YouTubers, as you would say it, and you will find...
There we go. Great bit of camera work.
That's fantastic. With the future. You can find the YouTubes, all of our games out there, each segment. And you can watch those anytime you'd like. Our thanks to Munson Healthcare Cadillac Rehab Services for their support and sponsorship of these broadcasts. Fitz got a nice little pass going there. See how he walks away? He's like, no, you got to work now.
That's the official that I was referencing with the Kahani bit there. So clearly what he's doing right now is working on the future. He's like, hey, kid, I want to be your buddy. Let's play a little chess pass. Let's play a little bounce pass. And then when you grow up and you're playing and I'm calling your game, and if you think I made a bad call, you're going to remember this night.
Well, he is,
and you're not going to yell at me.
He is kind of playing on his own over there in the corner. That could be the official's son for all we know.
Yeah, I don't know. Good point. Let's say it's not. Let's go with my story.
No, I like your story. But if it is the official's son, he's a very well-behaved young man as he just sits there and plays at the bottom of the bleachers. He's got a couple cars, vroom, vroom.
Give me a couple Hot Wheels and a Tuesday night, I'm set.
Foul was on McDaniel, and it will send Zimmerman to the line for a couple. Minute 9 remaining in this one. Anyway, as mentioned, Friday night we will be broadcasting as the Cadillac boys. I shouldn't say that without, there he is, without actually checking before I talk.
Let's race. My paper versus your computer.
The Vikings will take on Alpena.
Dang it.
As Kevin goes through his old school.
Yep, there it is.
Oh, look at the way date book. It looks like it's going to be Alpena. All right.
How dare you. Uh-oh. Yeah, that'll be a double.
That would be a double.
I want to see Spencer Fisher get a basket because it makes me feel better about myself since he lit me up a few times at the Y.
Reimer, nice little give back for Cooper. Can't get the baseline jumper to go. Nathan Dupuy has checked into the game for the Blazers. 53 seconds remaining in this one. Cochran going baseline. Tough shot, won't go. Shelby Diamond on the defense, and then the putback. Finally, Cochran gets it to go. Oh. And Zimmerman will draw the foul on McDaniel. I like to make sure I mention every name that comes back into the book, gets into the game. .6 remaining in this one. Zimmerman goes 1 of 2. Cochran with the rebound. 30 seconds left in the Vikings' 7th victory of the season. The Blazers will fall to 1-9. As Nathan Dupuy taking advantage of his time, working hard defensively, hitting the floor. Way to hustle, young man. I like your number. I wore number 22. Doing it proud. Him and Tanner Cochran both.
For what sport?
Tiddlywinks. Foul on the Blazers, 11 seconds remaining. You didn't think I played basketball in high school.
Were you all-state tiddlywinker?
No, I was all-regional pick, but there's some politics at the state level.
It's not bad, though.
Yeah.
Did you make a deep run?
Well, it's just one of those things. You got to know the right people at the state level to get all-state.
Gotcha.
Cochran padding his rebound totals. Can't get the putback to go. And Reimer will let the clock run out. 55-28, your final, as the Cadillac Vikings defeat the Kalkaska Blazers here at Cadillac High School. This 26 Sports and CCTV presentation of boys basketball action brought to you by Munson Healthcare Cadillac Rehab Services, Cadillac Tire, High Point Cadillac GMC, and Pizza Plus. We'll take a moment, collect our stats and thoughts. The post-game show coming up right after this.